there is a diagram. Actually, you can see about it, like in a normal product world, how actually like you're going to get that. So this is actually like you can say this is a UML about the product one. So you have category, from the category you have trying to get the different functions associated with that. Then you have the product, okay, from that. So then you have product, you have many functions, and then you will get the different related things with the product, and the same product will go to the cart, okay. And finally, like you are going to give the details of that. So this is like just not the context of our, it's like this will be help you to the for our context, actually what we are doing for our project, actually for purchase order, and that we are going to see. This is actually like the same thing which I actually like trying to get you the feature of that. Actually like someone actually like the current user, okay, he will be the customer or he cannot be a customer. If it is customer, we have already the details from him. What is the current user state? Then the user have a account. What is the details of that? Then he have a shopping cart, actually previous order and all that. And then this one is like for the order. He's going to get from the product. He's going to give the orders. And what is the current status of the order? It's actually new, hold, save, delivered, closed. We can get it that. And then the product, it will come into the line item. So that will be the complete order will be come onto that. So this whatever actually we want to do, actually like to get that. Initially the customer will order, then will be payment, then it will be going for delivery and other part of it. Everything need to restart. Pega server also like need to restart again. Just give me 1 minute. It's everything shut down. So today we are going to start the topic of validation, okay. What do you mean by validation? So normally what's the use of validation in normal world, right? A lot of there will be a lot of business rules actually we want, it need to be checked, right? Actually like if you are going for different things, right? Open the tool. Yeah. So you have a lot of constraint. It's like the value should be like if you are saying you are applying for a meeting, right? That should be a business day. It's not, should not be in holiday. You should not be within the office time. So you cannot apply for anything off office hours, right? And so if you person meeting up, so all that are actually like a normal validation which you want to put across your system. So how you should behave, right? It should be available or not, okay? And if you are getting some values, Actually, it should display description of that. It should not display the code of it. So there are a lot of constraints and the business rule we want to put in our application to get the correct application picture of to work it function properly. So that actually we achieve from the validation. We need to put some logic. We need to put some conditions so that unnecessary information or unwanted information or we cannot capture in our application. So that's actually we have captured using the validation. So in Pega, there are different ways we can get the validation. Okay. So validation, we normally like we can say one actually we call as dictionary validation. Okay. So within the dictionary validation, actually what are the things comes up? Actually first, actually by default, actually by the mode of the property, actually we define that, okay, it's a text, it's an integer, okay. There we define that, we cannot going to put onto that. So that's the first, actually we say with the type, okay. With the type of the property, we put that validation. So in a text, we can input only the like all the alphanumeric or special character into that. In numeric, we cannot enter any view alphabetic or special character into that. If it is decimal, then only we are going to insert the decimal dot after that some values. If it is integer, we cannot. So that actually we come from the type. Okay. Then actually there is with the type, we define one more field we call as UI control. Actually like any property if you open, that is actually like decide that what type of UI control you want to put that. So when you are going to display it to the user, what control you want to show that. So for a date time, like if it is a date time property, so we want to enter that user should only date time onto that and proper format. So there actually a UI control like PF date time. Okay. So that will control that whatever we are going to enter in a proper format. So same thing actually for different things, actually for the integer, we have UI control as PX integer. I'll show you that as well, PX integer. Okay. The next actually we call this list of values applicable for a field. So that actually we got from the table. Like we have that I told right, pickup list. Normally we are doing with the pickup list from the front end. But there are multiple options, actually we call it local list. Like it's all the different way of getting the values. Prompt list, class key, field value, or remote list. So these are the different options which we can control the values for the property. So if actually like if you are going to enter any values, that should be matched with the pickup list. We cannot enter any other values which is not there in the pickup list. So that's we are going to control from the list of values. So I'll tell you this one. There we'll discuss more. Okay. Then we have edit input. This one we have discussed what is the edit input. So it's going to format the input values. So if you see in the example, like from lowercase to uppercase. So this one actually you want to put the phone number, okay, the phone number should display like that, like plus, it should be the plus number, should add with the plus, okay, 001, so that's actually your international code, then hyphen, and 078-078 minus 4567, right, so that's like, if user is input like that, this will be like user is input it just 078 and 4567 that you want to convert in the same in this format. So that actually we can achieve from the edit input rule. So we can format the output in a proper format. So same thing like if you want to input the date and all that, we can do from the edit input. Then we have edit validate. Edit validate is going to mainly like this rule is we can use for a specific expression, right? Actually, it should be in a proper expression. So in email should be in a proper format. Phone number should be in this format. So that we can, if it is that in format or not, we can check that using regular expression. So normally most of the time, actually edit validate is used to do that, regular expression check, okay? So these are the mainly like we come on the dictionary validation. These five things we normally comes into the dictionary validation. Then we have UI label validation. So in UI, actually like we make as, you can have in the properties panel required or not required, read only or not, right? Read or editable, we can set able to do that. Then we can have visible, not visible conditions. Then we have disable condition. So there actually like we are going to set this. There also in there we have the custom, what is the minimum and maximum character. We can able to apply there as well. So this all we can put into the UI label. During the UI, we can able to set that up. Okay. Visible, disable, read only, required. Okay. So these are the we can able to different options we can put across the UI. And during the UI, we can put onto that. Then we have a rule called as declare constraint. Okay. So declare constraint is actually like another rule actually which is defined on a property. So if you want put actually like the property should be in a proper range and it should be required or all that, we can set using the declare constraint rule. Okay. We'll discuss on that declare constraint rule. The next type of validation is called as OBJ methods. Okay, like we normally like that is actually we are going to apply on the object. Okay, so there actually like we have a rule called as type of the rule, validate type of rule. Okay, and that validate rule we can use it multiple places. We can that use it in the case label. So normally like when we are doing the case, we have by default we have two validate rule, on add and validate. So validate rule is going to use only in case of saving of the case, and this will be while creating of the case. Okay. Then we have in activity, in flow action rule. We have a validation tab. We can mention about this value. Okay. The next we can apply in the activity. So in activity we have page validate. There are some methods. We will go into actually activity. There actually I'm going to tell you there as well more. Page validate, property validate. Okay, so there are, and then we have OBJ validate. So we have this different validation methods to validate the property, like how we are going to validate the property. Okay. then there is another method we have actually like we can set the message. We have called as property set message. Okay. So there actually like using the when rule we can able to clear that property clear message page clear messages. So these two we can able to use property set message. So there are two more messages we can able to use that. Okay, property set message and then so these are the different ways we can put the validation in Pega. Okay. Yeah. So let's start with once actually the system start. Yes, system start now. Good. And across all that, there is one more thing, final thing comes to observe, client side validation and server side validation. So what do you mean by client side and server side validation?
Yeah, client side means the browser side, right?
Right. Actually, like as soon as user is inputting things, right, it will be validated in the client and it will be immediately it will display to you.
Yeah.
Right. And server side, what will happen? Actually, you need to take some actions. The complete detail will go to the server. Okay. And then the complete validation will come happen in server. Again, response will come back to the client. And then it will be displayed to the user. So that is actually like the difference, client side and server side. So server side, actually like nowadays actually everyone needs client side validation itself. As soon as I enter, I want actually the actually I'm entering correct or wrong on that. So we'll talk about that, how we can achieve actually these two features as well. Like how the validation is happening. Is it client side or is it server side? I think we will not able to complete this one. Let's see if we will start with this one and then we'll see more details about that. So let's say we have the property total amount. Okay, we have many properties. So let's see one of the properties here. Okay, so now you can see this is the type. Okay, so first thing which I describe. So it is a decimal type, so it is going to allow only decimal type property in that. Okay. Then I talked about the UI control. So there actually you can see that it is coming as number. So it is not going to allow anything other than number. Okay. So you can see a lot of list will be there in this. Okay. So you can see there are all are Pega dependent things which actually given by Pega. PX URL, PX text area. So there are ample numbers of the controls are defined on that. And you can define your own controls as well. Actually there is a way you can define your own way of controls as well. Like which is like Pega is not given. So you can able to do the that is like beyond the course, but it's possible. Actually, it's, if you want to include anything in your part, you can able to do that as well. Okay. So this is like we have controls. Okay. Next, if you talk about the list, right? So these are the different things: local list, field value, class key, remote list, and prompt list. So normally, like if any we have defined any, in the customer we have defined, right? Let's see, pick list. So if you say any property with the customer. We have defined that customer type. Okay. So in customer type, we can see that we have defined that as a prompt list. So in prompt list, what this is mean that, so this is the actual value, standard value, and for user you are displaying that. So normally, like if you say employer ID 1234, okay, you want to display the name there. So that we can achieve from the prompt list. So normally, if it is local list, it will be going to display standard value only. But in case of a prompt list, so the value is different, but we are prompting users some meaningful values. Okay, so we are not going to identify the person. Actually, if it is one, who is that? Like two, who is that? So if it is display the name, we are able to distinguish them. So that is actually the way we can able to identify the prompt values. Okay, so there it will be going to different that. So that's the prompt list. Okay, then we have field value. Okay, so what do you mean by field value? Is field value is another way of doing this. Like here, what actually we say, in future if you have to add one more values here, so what you need to do, you need to make the changes, you need to change the property once again, right? So if you don't want to change the property in this way, we normally go with the field value way. So there is actually like the property which is the work status. Actually, what is the different work status we are going for? So there is a property called as PY status work. Okay, so you can see that completed, failed, in progress, new, open, pending, pending approval, pending external, pending fulfillment, right? So there is a lot of things you can see it here. Resolve, resolve duplicate, right? So most of the things are the field values for the single same field with a different property value of that. So all these are defined for the PY status work. So if you go for this one, the value of the drop down as a field value, you will see all this as a drop down there. So if you, that one, so this is the another way to get the list item. So that actually we called it field value. So how you can going to create that? So okay, I'll show you how you can create a field value rule. Okay. So let's just for the same field, okay, PY status work, I want to add a one more condition. Okay, pending delivered. Okay, this is not there. So we want to go with that option. So for this, let's say if I want to open the property once again from the work class of the property. Okay. Or you can open anything. Okay, pending fulfillment. Okay. So currently, like it's actually I'm going to save as this rule. So there actually in case of labor, I want to give the new values to it, pending delivery. Okay, so this is actually going to add in a new into the my rule set with the same work class. Okay, so let's I created that. Okay, so I'm not yet saved it. Actually, I'll show you where the it will be going to reflect you. So let's say you have the case. Okay, so you have the select product. Okay, so you can see set case status is here. So here you can see now, oh, pending delivery scheme now. Okay, so you can see that which one we have created, it's also already come here, pending delivery. So it's already created. Okay. So that actually that place we are able to see that that value is in the drop down. It automatically all the these are the all the field values is associated with that. So all this actually like, if you create one more field value, it is going to show you there in the list so that we can able to see as a valid values for work status. Okay. So that's the field value, and other two are actually you can able to we can relax with that. As of the now, we don't need that, so we can no need to go for that. Like remote list and class key value, not required as of now. Okay, so let's leave that one. So this is we see about the type UI control list of values. Okay, edit input, edit validate already I discussed when we discussed about the property, right? So that actually if you can see any email or the customer, we can able to see that. So we have say customer, we have phone number and email, there we have used the two things on that. So if you see email, okay, there will be you can see the you can have already. Edit validate tool is used in that one. So if you see the control, you can see PX email. Okay, in advanced tab, if you go to that, you are using a edit validate tool to validate the format of email. Okay, so it's using the Java library to check it out. Okay, so that time we can go for edit validate tool. So that's actually good. Edit input and edit validate. Okay. So the next is the UI label. So you can see UI label, if you see the respective form, okay. So normally for a so if you see any property, like you can see it like, okay, you have this property, okay, total amount. So you can able to set many things, right? The visibility, because we have made that as a read only, all the disable and other things are not coming. Okay, so what is the default value? Okay, what the visibility you want to put into that? Then in the presentation tab, actually we can see I made it as read only, so that actually is going to take the property value. Okay, how you want to control that? You can see that out, and then basically I talked about this one minimum, maximum. How you want to align that? So that is the number you want to align in the left, right side or left side. You want to put any, and if it is a decimal one, how you want to going to control that? Okay, how many decimal number you want? So you want to just two decimal or not? So that actually we can see that it should be rounding or not. So there we have multiple condition for rounding. Okay. So that we can, if it is a negative number, what format we want for that. So everything is we can have to control that. Okay. So if you say the purchase date, this is a date field. So what type of the format of the date you want to put into that. So here you can say that visibility, disable, required, the three things are there. Okay. And if you go to the presentation tab, currently like you can see minimum and maximum character, because this is an input field. Oh, I'm not taken as a purchase date as a date, so that's why it's coming as text input. Okay, so there you can see that the minimum and maximum character what you want, you can put it here. So if it is put that, so the minimum, if you say you just should input 5 characters at minimum, so that will be the minimum character, and maximums he should put 50 characters. So more than 50 it will not allow in that box, so that we can able to set it here. And if you want to any point of time, if you want to change the type of the thing, so it's really like you see I want to change that to a date. Okay, so you can see that I have the date, I change it to date. So with the date, what is going to do that in the presentation tab, the control will change. Okay, so you can see now you have changed, everything is changed. So what type of date time you want to put it there? You want to display as a date, as a time, or just date time. Okay, Okay, here you can see that you have text input, calendar text, and as a drop down list, so that you can control that. So the display mode, how you want to display that, you can able to control this out. So this all we can able to do that from the control. Okay, so these are the different features which is available within the UI part of it. Okay. We're going to stop now and we'll continue with the validation from here. Like we'll see how we can go with the remaining type of validation, and then we'll talk about the client side and server side validation. Sorry for short class. Okay, so we'll continue on tomorrow's for the further things.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I think I have a question, but it's, I think it's about the other class. Maybe I'll send you an email. All right.
Sorry, Jacob, for which?
I have a question, but it's about the other class, not this one. So I'll send you an email.
To Ashok, right? Yeah.
Yeah, I'll send it. I'll send you an email.
Okay. Ashok?
Yeah. I'll send an email tonight after this class. Oh.
Sure, Jacob. Okay, that will be fine. So you can able to see. I think he can able to get back to you after that.
Yes, I will do that. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks, Jacob.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you.